Philippine Senator Aimee Marcos questioned the decision to assign four Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement or EDCA sites in Luzon. During the Senate Committee on Foreign Affairs General Inquiry on Wednesday, Marcos said if the basis in choosing the sites is to accelerate humanitarian assistance and disaster response, then other climate-vulnerable provinces should have been picked.
Why is Giwan Samar, which the United States used during Yolanda, not on the list? It is clearly among the hardest hit among the provinces, and yet we seem to have forgotten the military base that was utilized by the Americans during Yolanda. Bakit po hindi kasali yan? Samantalang doble-doble yung Cagayan.
The four new EDCA sites are the Naval Base Camilo Osias in Santa Ana, Cagayan, Lalo Airport in Cagayan, Camp Melchor de la Cruz in Gamu, Isabela, and Balabac Island in Palawan. Defense Officer in Charge Carlito Galvez Jr. said disaster response is not the only consideration in picking the locations for EDCA sites. He stressed the sites seek to provide total defense of the archipelago, adding the country's vulnerabilities are in the north.
The instruction of the president is for us to prepare for external defense. And with that, we are trying to really allocate some resources and our modernization program on the northern side. If you look at the configuration of the armed forces strategy, our vulnerabilities is in the north.
In the north? I come from the north, sir. I don't feel very vulnerable. Our fishermen in Cagayan and the Ilocos Seas are not being harassed by anyone.
Madam, if you look at the defense strategy that we will be having, if we are interested on maritime security, our northern part is very, very weak.
According to Galvez, the locations are very strategic.
Strategic to whom? Is it strategic for us?
It's or strategic for us.
For the U.S. Because I share the sentiments of for a good chairperson that if humanitarian and disaster response will be one of the core goals of this agreement, then common sense will dictate that the president should be located in disaster-prone area.
Armed Forces of the Philippines Chief of Staff General Andres Centino also defended the selection of Cagayan and Palawan as EDCA locations.
We are projecting forces in the islands. We are projecting forces on the south of Palawan, a very strategic location wherein it's part of the Balabac Strait. And hence, by choosing Balabac and Santa Ana, where we have the naval base and the forward operating base of the Air Force in these two areas, we are able to strategically deploy our forces in these areas.
But Marcos appears to be unconvinced. For the senator, the expansion of the EDCA sites, particularly into the northern portion of the Philippines, may only drag Manila into the conflict over Taiwan.
Shall we allow the storage of material for Taiwan operations?
Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo assured the senator the Philippines will not allow the U.S. to stockpile weapons for use in operations in Taiwan in EDCA locations.
If that should ever arise, that eventuality, we will be guided by the main purposes of the EDCA as stated in those relevant paragraphs. And we would not agree to any kind of activity or even materials not consistent with these agreed activities. EDCA is not aimed at any third country outside. It's meant for the use of the Philippines and, of course, in connection with our treaty with the United States.
Although the new sites have already been announced, Manila and Washington have yet to finalize a written agreement, leaving the senators baffled.
Confused. There is an annex, but it's subject to an exchange of notes, or there is no annex, which is why you have not been able to provide the committee with a copy. Which is it, Bob?
There is an annex to the EDCA, and once we have agreed on an exchange of notes, we would be adding to that annex the new locations. But we're still in the process of negotiating the substance of the notes with the U.S.
In the five initial EDCA locations, six of the remaining 16 projects are expected to be completed this year. These include the runway project at the Basa Air Base, the storage facility at the Mactan Air Base, and the HADR warehouse at Fort Magsaysay. Only five EDCA projects have been completed so far. Manalo says the U.S. government has earmarked an additional $18 million for the construction of EDCA projects, which will be on top of the $100 million earlier announced by the United States. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.